Hello, my name is Penny Kettering, and I'm a member of the Hempfield Church of the Brethren, and I serve on part of the Deacon Committee. And I have been asked to do a video of how we make communion bread here at church. And as you can see, I am in the church kitchen. But before I begin this, I just wanted to take a few words from our Deacon Manual that states, communion is an ordinance established by Jesus the night before he died. He wanted to share his last meal with his disciples. And as they were eating, he took the bread and he broke it and he said, "Do this in remembrance of me." So for many years, the Brethren people had been carrying on this tradition of baking bread for communion. And we do it about twice a year. The first is on a Maundy Thursday, which is the evening before Good Friday. And then the second time we share communion is the first week in October, which is Worldwide Community Sunday. So I'm going today to share with you how our church makes the bread using the church recipe. And as you can see, this is how we use our big bowl. This is our big bowl for mixing our flour, salt, and butter. And we do all of this by hand. But in order for you to be able to actually see how we do demonstrate this and make it, I'm going to put this in a smaller bowl. First of all, we have 2 cups of flour. And this is an all-purpose regular flour. To that, I'll add 1/2 teaspoon of my salt. And then we put 1 stick of butter plus 2 tablespoons in, and this is 2/3 cup of butter. And what we'll do, we work it with our hands as we do in the big tub until it becomes mixed in with the flour to a meal. And when you do this at home, and if you have any gluten-free people that you cook for, I'm sure you could substitute the flour with a gluten-free flour. And if there's a dairy problem, you could also substitute almond milk for your liquid or even water. This just takes a few minutes. And what we want to do is get it to the consistency of a pie crust, a meal. And we want to make sure, too, that our butter is at room temperature. It's much easier for us to work it through the flour to get it to the point where we want to get it. And when we make it at church, all the deaconesses are welcome to join in this preparation. We want to make sure there are no big clumps of butter, so we're still working it a little bit here. It's finally coming to the stage I would like to have it. And if you can see, it's just almost like a pie dough, pie crust consistency. Now that we have our butter mixed with our flour, such as pie crust, we're going to add 1 cup of liquid. And in this demonstration, I'm using half cream, heavy cream, that we use at church, and half and half. I've made a little well in my flour and butter and simply pour it in. And with a spoon, or likewise at church, we use our hands to mix this step of the wet liquid with our flour and butter. And we mix it until it starts to pull away from the side of our container, our bowl. It's almost ready. Now, if you find that it's a little too dry, you might add more wet liquid. Or if it's a little too sticky, we add a little more flour. So once it's thoroughly mixed, I'm using my trusty pastry mat here, which I love. We're going to dump our dough out. And we're going to to start kneading it with our hands. And this is done when we are deaconess. We divide the dough into however many deaconess we have handy. And what we end up doing is kneading the dough. And this seems like it's just a little too dry, so I'm going to go ahead and add a tiny bit more liquid. We divide our dough into 10 balls, and the 10 does not represent anything other than we have 10 cookie sheets that we use. I think out of this recipe, you would probably get 2 or 3 balls. I think this would be a fun activity for your children. You could break off pieces and let them knead it. Our goal here is to eradicate any air bubbles that's in the dough. We want to end up with a smooth, somewhat elastic dough. This process takes between 5-8 minutes, and it's just a feeling that we get when we knead our dough. This is about ready, although it's not been 5 minutes. I think you get the gist of it. You can actually feel the dough being put together. Sometimes when we're not quite sure here, as deacons, we'll take a sharp knife and cut through the dough to see if there are any air bubbles in the dough. And we keep kneading it until we feel that it's a good, round, smooth, elastic ball. Then we take it over and put it on our cookie sheet. And we use this as a cookie sheet. Many years ago, I think some member of our church made these for communion. And today we still use that same sheet. The only difference is we apply a piece of parchment paper. That helps it from getting too brown. So once our ball is ready, we take it over, smash it down, and we each roll it, and we try to roll it into the shape of our cookie sheet, filling the edges. And I've already pre-rolled this, so you can see it's not a completely perfect shape, but it fills up the cookie sheet pretty quickly. Once that is done, we have a special rolling pin used for scoring. And what we do is gently but firmly roll this over our dough. And this is what makes our impressions on the dough. We roll it both ways. Each square is about 1 inch. And it simply makes an impression. Now, the last and most tedious part of our job, this is what it looks like once we've scored it. We will then prick each square, and we do this using a 3-pronged fork. This is pretty time consuming. And what we do, we prick each piece 5 times, 5 rows. These pricking marks represent the piercings that Jesus endured during his crucifixion. He was lashed as he carried his cross. They put a crown of thorns on his head. They put nails and in his feet and hands. And they put pierced a spear into his side. So this takes quite a while, as you can see. The 3-pronged fork is indented several times, and we use one of the prongs to put in the third hole, so that makes 5 marks across. After we've done that, this is what it should look like. We've already preheated our oven to 350 degrees, so this will go in the oven, and we bake that for about 15 to 20 minutes. And after the 15 minute mark, we start watching it very closely because we don't want it to burn or get too brown. Once it's baked to where we like to see it, we then remove it from the oven, slide it off of the cookie sheet onto one of the big metal tables back there, and let it cool for about 5 minutes. This is what we end up with, the pieces. We gently break them, and as you can see, this is our communion bread that we share. Also, we are very careful to keep several of the pieces together, and we use these basically for our love feast. When you sit across from one another, we have our simple meal of soup. We grab each piece and we break the bread together, just as Jesus did. So there you have how we do it at church. Now I'm going to continue to show you how you can do this in your home. And hopefully you will be sharing it with your children. We're going to go back to our roll of dough. I'm just going to move that aside a little bit. Get our rolling pin. And I would roll it to a consistency of perhaps a quarter of an inch to no more than a half an inch. And the children can help you do this as well, and as you do it, you can talk about Jesus, tell them stories, and let them be a real part of this procedure. Okay, now when you have your dough as thick as you'd like to have it, you can use a pizza knife for cutting strips and squares, as you've seen us do. Or perhaps you'd like to make round circles, and I just simply have a glass that I cut the shapes into. Or even better yet, if your children have a cookie cutter that they would like to use, let them do that. And once you have your shapes cut out, just transfer them over to your cookie sheet. And again, we have parchment paper. I'm a great fan of parchment paper. Put this through a little bit more. Okay, you just line your cookie sheet with your different shapes that you've made. I think you can get the idea from the little experiment that I've done here. And I prick it several times. This is simply so it doesn't bubble up. So then I would put this in your oven and bake it for perhaps 10 to 15 minutes. Keeping a close eye on the browning of it. Depends on the shape and how much dough you have in each shape that's going to determine how long it takes to get it done. This is what perhaps the finished product would look like. I've made several different little shapes. And I think this would be good to, on Maundy Thursday, if your family and you would like to have the love feast meal with a simple soup, you can share these wafers as well. Have some fruit. Tell stories of Jesus. I think it's very important that we familiarize our young people with what goes into preparation and the meaning of our love feast. And I just want you to remember that Jesus said, "Do this in remembrance of me." Thank you for watching this video. Happy baking. and happy Easter.